SCP-5847 is a food court. Literally. When food is consumed within the food court, it transforms into a courtroom where the individual who consumed the food is tried for everything they have ever eaten. By everything they have ever eaten. First up, would you like to tell me a bit about who you are and your history on the site?
So first, I'd just like to say thanks for having me on. I first found the site back in 2017 from an Ask Reddit post that was looking for interesting declassified government documents. Someone in the comments mentioned SCP, I think it was like 1171, Humans Go Home. I read it and kind of enjoyed it, but went about my life. Over the next 4 years or so, I read the site in short bursts, getting super interested in reading stuff for about a month and then ignoring it for a long time. I didn't actually get a Wikidot account and join the site until May of 2020, and I didn't start writing until the 22nd of July this year. I've actually deleted 3 out of 4 of my first works, since even in just this little time, I think my writing has improved enough that those pale in comparison.
Oh wow, you've definitely written quite a bit since then. Okay, how would you describe SCP-5847?
You've actually covered it pretty well right at the beginning there already. So I'll give my best shot at describing it out of universe. It's based off a pun name, The Food's Court, so of course it has to include over 50 puns. I've counted, it's in the 60s. All in all, it's a pun-filled rampage of legal jargon.
So proving to a bunch of food that you weren't just eating them for the sake of eating them seems like a pretty tough task. Is it safe to imagine they don't get proven innocent very often?
Given the fact the Foundation knows a possible ruling is that the subject is not guilty and free to go, we can assume someone has survived at least once. But I wouldn't go as far as to say it's happened more than once. It's interesting to imagine what that one person who is let free must have eaten throughout their life. Probably just like some poor sap who starved to death or something.
This was actually your first article, right? Could you tell me a little bit about your process in writing it, and how you got the idea?
I was actually having a lot of trouble coming up with an idea for an SCP, and had avoided writing one for quite a while. I had written some tales in GOI formats, but I couldn't write an SCP I was happy with for the life of me. I ended up basically giving up and tried writing something for another wiki, The Backrooms. I got it all written up in the style Backrooms pages are written in, but then I realized the audio log was really the only good part of the article. I ended up extracting that audio log from that article and used it as the base of the food's court, so the entirety of the courtroom scene wasn't written with the intentions of being an SCP. After writing one SCP, I was able to start getting into the groove, and now I'm up to 8.
There's already at least one other article based on yours, SCP-6847. Do you think eventually this concept could catch on and there will be a giant SCP cinematic universe based on food puns that you created?
It's funny you should bring that up, because there's actually a couple more related articles being worked on at this very moment. I have a GOI format article written from the perspective of Wilson's Wildlife Solutions, but the version of the word solutions that means a liquid. That's about a bear they've captured that's anomalous because it looks completely different from all their normal beers, spelled B-E-E-R, in their world. I also know another writer is working on an Apollyon SCP that's just our world written about from the perspective of the Sausage, Carrots, and Potatoes Foundation's perspective. If this does get big enough to get its own canon, I've already got the name picked out. It's the Food Isles, spelled I-S-L-E, like islands. I'd like to give a quick shout out to Green Golem for coming up with that name. He's the writer of the other article you mentioned, SCP-6847, The Ambassador.
It's a really goofy, fun idea, and I think it would make a great canon. The ridiculousness of the situation is highlighted especially by the massive amount of puns in the article. Some of them get pretty esoteric. Some people might say that it's unparable. What did you have to sorbet to those people? I'm sorry.
It's a grape article, so it's pretty uncool-aid of you to not like it.
Okay, that's about it for today. Would you like to promote anything here? Other accounts, projects you're working on, etc., etc., etc.?
Alrighty, I'm just going to go ahead and plug my two favorite articles of mine. First is my favorite SCP, SCP-5846, The One-Stop Shop, about a morphing building. And the other is a tale, The Log of Non-Anomalous Items. Which is exactly what you think it is. They're not anomalous. Anyways, thanks for having me. It was a very fun interview.
Thanks for being here. Okay, that's all for today. Go check those out.